Christ Jesus' body, blood, soul, and divinity, we come to offer you all of the fruits of this retreat. We deposit them before your majesty as through the hands of our Mother Queen, your Mother Queen, Mary. Mary, we thank you for interceding for us. Thank you for allowing us to look deeper into the mystery of who you are. Allow us as we grow in understanding you more, that truly will help us to appreciate the gift you are to us as a mother. You are a great gift to us. And how beautiful Christ Jesus before dying, before his last breath, almost as a death wish, before he dies, this is before I die, what a gift. Mary, thank you for being so empty of yourself as to be truly full and overflowing of the maternal love of God the Father, the Rahamim, mercy. Continue to intercede for us, Mother, in your merciful love, in your maternal love, that we may grow and fully reveal the image of Christ Jesus deep in our souls, that others may see us and see Christ. Help us, raise us, as you raise the child Jesus, raise us to the full stature of what we're meant to be in Christ Jesus. And Mary, intercede that the power of the Holy Spirit will continue to work within us. Holy Spirit, come upon us, power of the Most High, overshadow us. Overshadow us with that precious mantle, power of the Most High. Envelop us as you envelop Mary. Envelop us as you envelop Christ Jesus, and empower us to live out the fullness of our Christian dignity. We also come to deposit all the struggles and sacrifices that we endured in order to get here, and all the things that happened this week, we offer them, we lay them down, receive them through the hands of Mary. Let Mary magnify, let Mary be an instrument of healing it, repairing it, that it truly be worthy of your kingly dignity, Almighty God. And we also want to contribute all of this as we desire to build a throne, a wayside shrine where the Blessed Mother may continue to work with us, work with this parish, and work with many who will come and pilgrimage to receive of the fruit of our labors in collaboration with Mary. But also we deposit this in the desire that it may be received for the good of the whole conflict that's going on between Russia and Ukraine, invasion, and war. We unite ourselves to the entire Catholic Church under the direction of Pope Francis, who will be consecrating Russia and Ukraine to Our Lady of Fatima. So we too would like to contribute into that consecration by depositing all the efforts of this week. And as we pray together, as I pray, you can follow along the prayers of consecration that Pope Francis is getting ready to say, we unite in anticipation. Prayer of consecration. You may sit down so that your knees can hold the longest prayer. Prayer of consecration. O Mary, Mother of God and our Mother, in this time of trial, return to you as our mother. You love us and you know us. No concern of our heart is hidden from you. Mother of mercy, how often we've experienced your watchful care and your peaceful presence. You never cease to guide us to Jesus, the Prince of Peace. Yet, we have strayed from the path of peace. We have forgotten the lesson learned from the tragedies of the last century, the sacrifice of millions who fell into world wars. We have disregarded the commitment we've made as a community of nations. We've betrayed people's dreams of peace and the hope of the young. We grew sick with greed. We thought only of our own. refuse to ignore God, to be satisfied with our illusions, to grow arrogant and aggressive, suppress innocent life, and to stockpile weapons. We stop being our neighbor's keeper and steward of our common home. We ravish the garden of the earth with war. And by our sins, we have broken the heart of our Heavenly Father, who desire us to be brothers and sisters. We grew indifferent to everyone and everything except ourselves. Now in shame, we cry out, forgive us, Lord. Holy Mother, amid the misery of our sinfulness, amid our struggles and weaknesses, amid the mystery of iniquity that is evil and war, you remind us that God never abandons us. You continue to look upon us with love, ever ready to forgive us and raise us up to new life. Mary, He is giving you to us and made your immaculate heart a refuge for the church and for all of humanity. By God's gracious will, you are ever with us, even in the most troubled moments of our history. You're there to guide us with tender love. We now turn to you, knock at the door of your heart. We are your beloved children. In every age you make yourself known to us, calling us to conversion. At this dark hour, help us and grant us your comfort. Say to us once more, am I not here? Able to unite the knots of our hearts and our time, able to untie the knots of our hearts and of our time. In you, we place our trust. We are confident that, especially in this moment of trials, you will not be deaf to our supplications and will come to our aid. That is what you did at Cana in Galilee, when you interceded with Jesus and He worked the first of His signs. To preserve the joy of the wedding feast, you said to Him, they have no wine. Now, O Mother, repeat those words and that prayer. For in our own day we have run out of the wine of hope. Joy has fled. Eternity has faded. We've forgotten our humanity and squandered the gift of peace. We open our hearts to violence and destructiveness. How greatly we need your maternal help. Therefore, O Mother, hear our prayer, star of the sea. Do not let us be shipwrecked in the tempest of war. Ark of the New Covenant, inspire projects and path of reconciliation. Queen of Heaven, restore God's peace to the world. Eliminate hatred and the thirst for right, for revenge, and teach us forgiveness. Free us from war. Protect our world from the menace of nuclear weapons. Queen of the Rosary, make us realize our need to pray and to love. Queen of the human family, show people the path of fraternity. Queen of peace, obtain peace for our world. O Mother, may your sorrowful plea stir our hardened hearts. Tears you shed for us make this valley parched thunders of weapons. May your prayer turn our thoughts to peace. May your maternal touch soothe those who suffer and flee from the rain of bombs. May your motherly embrace comfort those forced to leave their homes and their native land. May your sorrowful heart move us to compassion and inspire us to open our doors and to care for our brothers and sisters who are injured and cast aside. Holy Mother of God, as you stood beneath the cross, Jesus, seeing the disciple at your side, said, "Behold your son." In this way, he entrusted each of us to you, to the disciple, and to each of us, he said, "Behold your mother." Mother Mary, we now desire to welcome you into our lives and our history. At this hour, our weary and distraught humanity stands with you beneath the cross, needing to entrust itself to you and through you to consecrate itself to Christ. The people of Ukraine and Russia, who venerate you with great love, now turn to you, even as your heart beats with compassion for them and for all those people decimated by war, hunger, injustice, and poverty. Therefore, Mother of God and our Mother, to your Immaculate Heart we solemnly entrust and consecrate ourselves, the Church, and all of humanity, and St. Cecilia in our parishes, especially consecrate Russia and Ukraine. Accept this act that we carry out with confidence and love. Grant that war may end and peace spread throughout the world. The fiat that arose from your heart opened the doors of history to the Prince of Peace. We trust that through your heart, peace will dawn once more. You consecrate the future of the whole human family, the needs and expectations of every people, the anxieties and hopes of the world. Through your intercession, may God's mercy, Rachamim, be poured out on the earth and the gentle rhythm of peace return to mark our days. Our Lady of the Fiat, on whom the Holy Spirit descended, restore among us the harmony that comes from God. May you, our living fountain of hope, water the dryness of our hearts. In your womb, Jesus took flesh, help us to foster the growth of communion. You once trod the streets of our world, lead us now on the path of peace. Amen.
Amen.
Let us prepare to receive the final lesson. God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'm going to go straight from here to the church and serve the Blessed Sacrament. Mass is about to begin. 9 minutes.